गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर इंग्लिश ग्रामर क्लास. गेट रेडी स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग. यस, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग अभिरूप, जोई, अग्निशा, बिपाशा. ओके, सो वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग. नाउ टेल मी इन द प्रीवियस क्लास व्हाट वी डिड. हु कैन टेल मी फर्स्ट? अद्रिजा. चैप्टर नंबर 18 वी वर डूइंग. एक्चुअली प्रोनाउन चैप्टर आई थिंक एच आई कंप्लीटेड, इजंट इट स्टूडेंट? एच कंप्लीटेड. सो टुडे वी विल कंप्लीट दिस चैप्टर एंड देन वी विल मूव टू चैप्टर नंबर 18. ओके, सो स्टूडेंट्स गेट रेडी. प्रोनाउन इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड इजी, इजंट इट स्टूडेंट? सो गेट रेडी. ओके, नंबर आई. ओके, आई. सो स्टूडेंट्स नंबर वन, आई एम रेडी टू हेल्प यू, यू कैन डिपेंड अपॉन मी. नंबर वन, आई, यू, मी. ओके, नंबर टू, वी आर गोइंग टू चित्रा'स birthday party. Okay, she has invited all of us. Number three, don't tease the dog, it may bite you. Okay, yes. Next, number four, Manju has two brothers, they are older than her. Right students? Number five, can you lend me your pen for a while? I have misplaced it. Okay, number six, this story is very interesting, have you read it? Okay, done students. Number J, use pronouns in place of the underlined nouns. Okay, use pronouns underline. Page number 49. Use pronoun. Okay. Still I am discussing. Use pronouns in place of the underlined nouns. This is Aslam. So we will write the pronoun in the place of Aslam. He is a big shopkeeper. All these shops are his. Okay. Number two, proteins are needed for the growth of the body. Proteins also help. So we will write they also help the body to replace dead cells. Eggs, milk, and cheese contain them. Number three, Kavita and Kapil are neighbors. They study in the same class. I am going to meet them. Number four, very few tigers are left in India. We should try to protect them. We should never kill them. Okay. Now, number K. This is my car. This car is mine. Number two, it was our gift. That gift was ours. Number three, these are their books. These books are theirs. Number four, that is his school. That school is his. Number five, these are her books. These books are hers. Number six, these are your shoes. These shoes are yours. Okay. Now, solve the puzzle. That is not needed, but you can do it at home. Okay, as a fun work. It will not come in the exam. So that is fun work you will do at home. Clear? Still I am telling the answer. Students, across, okay? Number L. Number L across. I cannot spare my book. She must use hers. Number three, we are very fond of books. All these books are ours. Number five, they entered the room because they thought it was. Yes. Next. Number seven. Dash is the head girl. She. Number eight, I am grateful to you. Okay, now down, okay? Can you see the board? Can you? Huh? Can you? Okay. Now? Okay, wait. Wait. Now it is clear, isn't it? The whole board? Okay. So, down. Number one. I have seen Mrs. Kumar on TV, but I have never met her. Number two. Why do you want to play with my bat? Have you lost? Yours. Very good. Number four. Give me my share. Number five, some people are waiting outside. Are they? Yes. Number six, he gave me all his books. He or she, okay? He gave me all his books. Okay, students? So, this chapter is completed. So, can I move to the next chapter? And I'm going to rub. Are you ready? Okay. Now, students, next chapter, verb. Okay? In short, we know doing words are verbs, isn't it? Naming words are nouns and doing words are verbs. Right, students? Page number 51, get ready. Okay. So, from page number 51, now move to page number 52. In short, doing words are verb, and why do we use verb? Because verb is used to say, verb tells us tells us something about a person or thing does. Okay, why do we use verb? Why verb is used? Because verb tells us about a person, about a person or a thing is, okay, or about a person or thing has. Okay, has means possession. Has refers to possession. And it also says what a person or thing does. That is doing word. And what a person or thing is. Okay. So, verb works three things. The first thing is, it tells us something about a person or thing. It says what a person or thing does, what a person is, and what a person or thing possesses. That is possession. Okay. Thing has. What a person or thing has. So, These are the features of verb, and we must remember that there can never be a sentence without verb. That means we cannot write a sentence without a verb. We cannot write a sentence, I mean meaningful sentence, okay? For example, if we write he a boy, okay, he a boy, it does not make sense. So he is a boy, or he, yes, he is a boy, he is a good boy. So verb is needed, it is must, okay? So now the thing is, a verb can be made up of one word, or it can be, a verb can be made up of two words. That means more than one, okay, two words, or more than two words, more than, okay. For example, he is a good boy. How many verb is here? Tell me, how many verb? One. Okay. Okay. He is going to school. Now tell me, verb. How many verbs? Isn't it? How many verbs? He will be leaving for, will be leaving, how many? Three. Understood? Okay. So, as I told you, a verb tells us something about a person or thing does. That means he is writing. Here the verb tells us about what the person is doing, okay? Understood? It denotes what he is doing. Next, a verb tells us what a person or thing is. For example, he is a good boy. Here it tells being, okay? Right, student? And it also tells us about a person. It also tells us about a person or thing. Has, okay, possession. He has a pen, okay? It shows possession, okay? So today up to this, students, bye.